We want to end this 4th of July with an effort to make sure one American is given the nation's highest military honor. He earned it more than a century ago. Here's Chip Reid.
Sergeant William Butler served with the renowned all-black 369th Infantry Regiment during World War I. His heroism made headlines after he killed at least five Germans while rescuing five Americans who had been taken prisoner. The 369th got a parade on their return, and Butler received the Distinguished Service Cross and France's highest military honor, but not the U.S. Medal of Honor.
No black received a Medal of Honor in World War I.
Professor Jeffrey Sammons of New York University says that's largely because of a concerted and well-documented effort by senior white officers to denigrate the performance of black soldiers.
They could do anything but fight.
They being African American soldiers.
Yes. They have in fact been dangerous to no one except themselves and women.
Sammons has joined forces with Professor Timothy Westcott of Park University in Missouri to right what they see as a terrible wrong.
And how are you going to fix that?
We're going to fix it with the best forensics and genealogical and historical research that we can possibly do.
Westcott and his students are combing through the records of more than 100 World War I minority service members who received the Distinguished Service Cross but might have deserved more.
I'm just astonished by what these men did.
Sophomore Joshua Weston is a veteran.
When you look at Caucasian members of the military, if they were to perform the same actions, they would be given the Medal of Honor in a heartbeat.
Their work is supported by bipartisan legislation now before Congress, which would require the Defense Department to do a systematic review of potential Medal of Honor candidates. Butler later took his own life and is buried at Arlington National Cemetery. Ashlyn Weber hopes his headstone will one day read Medal of Honor.
If I can do anything in my power to make sure that some of these men live again, I will do it.
A mission based on a belief that it's never too late to do the right thing. Chip Reid, CBS News, Parkville, Missouri.